We all know how great formative data captures such as quizzes can be for assessing student learning and having students self-assess how they're going, but we also all know just how time-consuming it can be to create those quizzes, especially with solutions with explanations. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how I use ChatGPT and Quizizz to create my quizzes for my students and do it without using much time at all. I'm talking 5 minutes per 10-question quiz with work solutions. If that sounds good to you, stay tuned because we're going to dive into it right now. Here I am on the OpenAI website. Try ChatGPT down the bottom here, and it'll open up a new window. If you haven't yet signed up, you'll have to create an account to use ChatGPT for now. I've already got one, so here I am on the homepage. And I'm a math teacher, but in this instance, I'm going to be using history as my example. So I might be teaching at the moment about World War I, particularly from the perspective of Australia's involvement. I am Australian, so that works for me. And I am going to say to ChatGPT now, create a 10-question quiz with multiple choice answers, showing me the correct answer and a brief explanation of that answer about Australia. I'm going to say about World War I, but mostly from the perspective of Australia's involvement. Right, so I'm telling it exactly what I want from it. So it's telling me here's a 10-question quiz about World War I, etc., etc. Sometimes, depending on how many people are using this program worldwide, it can be a little bit slow. It is artificial intelligence, but you know their servers do get overloaded, so bear with it. It will eventually generate all the answers for you. You can see them coming through now. So for example, in what year did Australia enter World War I? The answer is 1914. It gives me four options, tells me the correct answer. And then if, you know, the question calls for it, where, you know, there's two answers that might be similar, this is why I asked for the explanation. In those instances, you might want to give students an explanation to why it was A and not D, for example. The first one was pretty straightforward. We've got some more here. What was the outcome of the Battle of Gallipoli for Australia? Victory, defeat, draw, or surrender? The answer was B, defeat. And then it gives a little bit of an explanation about that. So first things first, ChatGPT does all the research and all the work for you. Quick disclaimer though, you better read these questions and answers because this program can be fallible, right? It can be wrong. So using your professional judgment, you should be checking these answers and just making sure they're correct. I'm not a history teacher, so I'm not going to go through these answers with a fine-tooth comb, especially because this is a demonstration at this point in time. But what I'm going to be doing once it's finished is I'm going to copy and paste all the questions and answers into Quizizz. So it's taking a little while to finish, so using the power of technology, let's speed up to the point where it's finished now. All right, and here it is, all 10 questions finished, and now I'm going to jump over to Quizizz. If you're not a member of Quizizz, you can sign up for free. It's my, quiz program of choice. There are so many out there, like Socrative. You got Google, Microsoft Forms you can use, heaps of different ones. I use Quizizz because I really like it. So if you want to follow along, feel free to use Quizizz. So I'm going to just now go to create a quiz. And I already have the questions and the answers, which is the beauty of ChatGPT. I didn't really have to do too much thinking, which was nice. So I'm going to go to multiple choice assessment, and I'm going to just jump back and forth now between ChatGPT and Quizizz. So question one, in what year did Australia enter the war? I'm going to copy and paste. So shortcut for those who don't know it yet, Command C, hold Command and then press C to copy, and then hold Command and press V to paste. So there's the question. And now I just copy the answers, 14, 15, 16, 17. These are easy to pop in. So 1914, 1916, 1915, 1917. And then the correct answer was 1914. So I just click that and then go save. Boom, done. Next question, It's another multiple choice. Scroll down. What was the main reason for Australia's involvement in World War I? Copy that, paste it in here, go back to the quiz. Loyal to Britain, economic interests, etc. These are slightly longer, so I'm going to type them so I don't have to remember them. But you can see while I'm doing this that it's super fast for you to create these quizzes. I'd say if I wasn't talking through it and I was using a keyboard and a mouse instead of my trackpad, I could probably, even with all the copy and pasting, create this 10 question quiz in about 5 minutes time. Honestly, it's not going to take you much longer than that. The answer for this one was loyalty to Britain, by the way, so I'm going to tick A. If you always, just as a side note about quizzes, just want to make A the correct answer so you don't have to overthink, then that's totally fine. When you create these quizzes and actually run them, you can set a setting such that it scrambles the answers. So the correct answer for some students might be C for this question, for others it might be D, and so on. You can put pictures and stuff in as well if you want, but the point of this video was to create a really fast quiz without too much time, because we are time poor, so I'm not going to waste time doing that. But if you have more time and you really want to create a really rich task for your students, that's how you can upskill and upgrade that. And I just want to show you how do you add this explanation here. I'm going to copy this explanation ChatGPT gave me, and over here in this add explanation section, click that and type the fun fact or whatever and click done, and then save, and so on. And so you can continue going through question one, question two, all the way down to question 10. I'm not going to do it, so, because this would be a very boring video if I did all the way down, but you can see how quick and easy it is to create a quiz on a program like Quizizz using ChatGPT's generative software, which is really, really amazing. If you want to learn more about how ChatGPT is going to be revolutionizing, really, education, I've got a video card on the screen where I go into depth about the opportunities and the threats that ChatGPT poses. So head on over to that video and I will see you in that one. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure you click like and you subscribe if you want more content. Otherwise, I'll see you over at the other video.